Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très heureux d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui. Thank you, Chancellor Schultz, for welcoming us so warmly. But thank you also, right off the top, for your tremendous leadership in a difficult time, whether it has been being incredibly strong on sanctions and punitive actions towards Vladimir Putin and the Kremlin for their absolutely abhorrent behavior, or whether it's with your support for Ukraine. It has been a joy to work with you these past many weeks on making sure that we are responding strongly to this threat, not just to friends, but to the very fabric of our democracies. I am very happy to be joined here today by our Deputy Prime Minister, Chrystia Freeland, and by our Minister of Foreign Affairs, Minister Mélanie Joly. And the meetings that we had and the lunch we just had was extremely beneficial and effective. Canada and Germany stand together against Putin's invasion. He represents a threat to democracy, to security, and to peace in Europe and around the world. This morning I spoke with President Zelensky and highlighted once again the strength and determination of the Ukrainian people and told him that Canada will soon be sending highly specialized equipment to them and invited him to address Parliament in Canada and he accepted. Le Canada et l'Allemagne collaborent de près pour soutenir le peuple ukrainien et son gouvernement. On a fait des envois d'équipements militaires, on est en train de renforcer l'OTAN, on envoie de l'aide humanitaire. On a mis en place des sanctions extrêmement sévères pour punir Poutine, les oligarques et les complices. Aujourd'hui, j'annonce un 50 millions de dollars additionnels pour envoyer des équipements militaires en Ukraine. Today, I can announce an additional $50 million worth of equipment that we will be sending towards Ukraine to help out. But more than just the challenge in Ukraine, there's a larger challenge around protecting and standing up for our democracies, both internally and externally. And that means fighting disinformation. We need to work together to defend and strengthen democracy for everyone in our countries. So today I can announce that Canada is renewing the G7 Rapid Response Mechanism. The RRM was first introduced at the G7 in Charlevoix that we hosted 4 years ago to strengthen coordination between countries submitted to influence and disinformation from foreign actors. It responds to threats from people who want to undermine our democracies, including through disinformation. In addition, $3 million will be provided to tackle Russian disinformation about Ukraine specifically. We need to stand up for truth and be vigilant against disinformation that tries to mislead us and more tries to divide us. La crise en Ukraine démontre l'importance de la sécurité énergétique et de l'accélération de la transition verte. Chancelier Scholz et moi avons parlé de ce qu'on fait pour établir des liens entre entreprises et investisseurs canadiens et allemands, entre autres pour l'hydrogène. On a aussi parlé de minéraux essentiels utilisés dans la technologie des batteries et des technologies avancées. On a souligné l'importance d'avoir des chaînes d'approvisionnement sûres et résilientes entre amis. Canada and Germany are aligned in our ambitious goals to reach net zero. We know that building a clean economy has the potential to expand trade, to grow the economy, and create good middle-class jobs and careers on both sides of the Atlantic. So we're working with Germany to expand the adoption of carbon pricing around the world. I was pleased to join Chancellor Scholz's G7 Climate Club proposal because this is about building a safe, healthy future for our kids and grandkids, both with cleaner air and better opportunities for them to succeed. Demain, je serai en Pologne pour discuter de la situation et la crise des réfugiés qui s'aggrave. And of course, Canada will continue to work with partners in Europe to defend democracy, to support Ukraine, and to build a safe and prosperous future for everyone. Thank you for everything, Olaf.